I appreciate that the theme of this dialogue is harmony. And also I would like to thank those who have organized this meeting. I would like to share with you some of the views and ideals of the Baha'i faith and also Baha'is, how to fulfill and achieve the world unity. The pivot around which all the teachings of Baha'u'llah, Baha'u'llah in English means glory of the Lord, he appeared about 150 years ago. All the teachings, the pivot around which is the oneness of humankind. So he wrote to the kings and emperors of the world and also the religious leaders of all faiths. He said, we are entering a new era, and the new era is based on unification of mankind. New era is based on universal peace. New era, the women must come on the stage and they will play a vital role for rebuilding the world and establishing world peace. He said that this new world, there must be justice, political justice, economic justice, and also social justice. You may ask me a question, how the Baha'i teachings can fulfill the unity of the world, which is the ultimate desire of all the people. Baha'u'llah did not express this unity of the world as a pious wish. Rather, he brought all the teachings which can fulfill that unity of the world. For example, first of all about the religion, we Baha'is believe in the divine origin of all the major religions of the world. I would like to clarify the word religion, because many people, they are misunderstanding. They put in denomination as a religion. For example, in Christianity, we have many denominations, Catholic, Baptist, Jehovah's Witnesses, different. But they are not different religions, they are all Christian. Anybody believing in Christ and believe in the Holy Bible, he is a Christian. He is a part of that religion. So all the religions of the world, from the beginning of the world until now, all over the world, is nine, no more than that. So we believe that in all the religions, the essence, the pivot is the spiritual values. Means all the religions have common together. The only thing difference we can see, there are two things. One, a religion has two aspects. One social aspect, one has spiritual aspect. The spiritual aspect, the spiritual truths are eternal truths. It's not rejected, but should be developed, or should be reinforced, or be expanded. But social aspect changes because every religion has been born in a special place, special time, special social conditions. So that's maybe different. But the essence, if we put, and also many religions, some superstition have been added to the religion, misunderstanding, misinterpretation, misconduct in the name of religions, that has made this problem. But if you take away all this, then go to the core of their religions, you can see all of them have something common, the same spiritual values. At the same time, today, you know, as we're reading those beautiful prayers and this, I really was sad, the first one, because we say the world is full of miseries, full of wars, sufferings. So this is a question. Is this, we are doomed to fight, to be suffered? We are doomed to be all the time miserable? Or there is a way, there is a suggestion, there is a guidance. This could be, we can disentangle ourselves of this old system and come to new. And Baha'u'llah, he brought something, how to bring about this unity. It's not just, he said, it's good to have a unity, it's good to love each other. He brought the teachings and also the system, how this unity can be a machine, can be embodied, can be perpetuated. He brought a new system. He said that all the systems today which breed disease must be rolled out. Because you can see, the First World War and Second World War, what is that? That's illness. Disease. They kill each other, millions of people. So what? Who benefit from that? First World War and Second World War, except killing the people. Because this, he said, this system brings disease. This is not suitable for this time. This is based on the old notions and old conditions of society. Now is the time for unification of mankind. Now is the time the world should be united. Now the time the women come on the stage. So he brought a system similar, he said there should be some type of world federalism, federation, like similar to Australia. For example, Australia has, each state has their own government, their own system, their internal autonomy, but at the same time, all of them are the federal system. So he said that the whole world should be under one world federation. And then each no country has the right to have army, no country has the right to make weapons. Only they can have a police force to keep the internal order. So he brought that, he said, it's a long discussion that the system, he said, every aspect of this system, how to bring about that unity, how to preserve that unity, how to perpetuate that unity. He brought that. So this is the time actually we people love God and belong to different religions, instead of rejecting each other, competing with each other, or sometimes even to make animism again, enmity against each other, we work together, hand in hand, to fight back the darkness, this darkness of materialism, because we have one common thing, spirituality. We have one common thing, we believe in God. So instead of that, all our energies must be directed to a new goal. That goal is unity of the world. If any idea, any belief, any tradition make an obstacle on the way of world unity, should be discarded. Do not stick to it too much. If that stops it, no more. You don't need that. What is, even the idea, religion, ideology, everything is for humankind, not humankind for them. It means the people should not be sacrificed for preserving a system or a belief or anything. Rather, the benefit of humankind should be considered. What is best for everyone? To have a happy time. We have a united world, a peace in the world. We love God, we love each other. And as our friend said that Christ is about God. One of the most beautiful teaching of Christ is about love, actually. We love it. That is very high level of standard, what he said. And also, Buddha also has many good teachings, and also how we can be, how we can train our mind, how we can be united. So this is the time we teach our children, is fostering their mind, the love of all humankind, regardless of their creed, their nationality, their ethnic backgrounds, or religion. And we do that actually in Baha'is. We train our children to love everyone. For example, I'm not a Christian, but at the same time, I bought a book, was special Bible for children. I bought the book, gave my children to read it. For this reason, they know Christ, they love Christ, to foster his love in their heart, and they know he has sacrificed his life for humankind. So they understand that. So the same thing we do about Buddha. We teach them who was Buddha. He suffered a lot, but he did everything for humankind. The same thing, Jesus Christ, Moses, Zoroaster, Krishna, they all did this. But they themselves are in unity. These followers of religion, they selfishness coming to, and they want to get my religion the best or the true one, other religions are false. We must forget that. This is the time humankind has the capacity to understand the unity of the world. We must all work together. Baha'u'llah said, I have not come to add a religion to the religions of the world. He said, I have not come for that. I have come to bring into fruition the efforts and endeavors of all divine teachers who have appeared in the world. He said that I have come to educate humankind to put their feet on the earth, to go so uplifted they will be. So this is the time, so we should be united together. With all our energies, we direct there for unity, love, and all the religions, we hand in hand, working together to feed back the darkness of materialism.